It's time to visit the next destination on this virtual journey through southern Halland, and we're going to talk about blockchain, and we're going to do it in Laholm. Blockchain got its breakthrough with Bitcoin in 2009, but since then a lot has happened with blockchain. With much easier access to all data at all levels, the future can be both faster, more secure and more accessible. The question is whether blockchain is just for the big companies or even the small one can benefit of this technology. Please welcome Sara Samani, Head of Disruptive Technologies at Metabytes.
Hi. And we have Victoria Ekman with us as well. I'm just going to sit here and I thought I'm going to be standing up, but it's fine. Yeah. So welcome. I'm Zara Zamani, Head of Disruptive Technologies at Metabytes. And today I'm here with you, with Victoria.
Yes.
If you could introduce yourself.
Yes, my name is Victoria Ekman and I run a company in a small little village here in Halland called Unnaryd together with my family and our poor employees that has to be with us every day. Yeah.
Great. And today, I can see them. Yeah. Today we are going to talk about blockchain in logistics, and we are looking at the case that we have with C Productor, the company that mm-hmm. Victoria is the CEO with, and we will just have a learning journey together. So the first question most of the times I am asked is, what is blockchain at all? And a lot of us are not really familiar, so we will just have a quick introduction of the technology, and then we will look more in depth in logistics. So blockchain is basically a system of recording transactions in a network in a way that is not possible to change, erase, or manipulate with it, which means it brings security and anti-corruption to the network. And it's a distributed ledger, means there is basically no intermediary, no middleman involved. And everyone in a network is connected with each other. It's a peer-to-peer network. That's what it means, that we are all connected without any middleman, without any central house of control. It's digital, and it's synchronized real-time. We all have the same record of all the transactions at the same time. And it's called trustless network because there is no central house that you need to trust to keep your data anymore. It's not that the trust doesn't exist. The trust is distributed in the network and is created by the network for each and each individual node itself. And it's time-stamped. That makes it auditable, so you can see what has happened in a network at what time by who. So it's irreversible because it's sealed. It involves encryption of the data, and you have a hashing system in the network. That means you cannot change or delete or erase any transaction. You will only be able to add a new block to the system. You cannot really do anything with the history. And that's why they call it immutable or irreversible technology. But what are the advantages of the technology? I'm just going to look at here sometimes because I can't see my slides very well from there. So it's having said all of these features of the technology, therefore it's a self-sovereignty technology that as an individual, now you have full control of your personal data. You own it and you have a control over it. This could be your personal data. If you're an organization, you have control over your organization data in the network that you're working with. If you take the logistics as an example, as a logistic company, you have ownership over your data in a supply chain, the network of supply chain that you're involved with. It introduces trust. You don't need to have trust anymore, let's say, in a bank to keep your accounts details. You distribute the trust in the network. And it adds transparency and provenance because you can see everything that is happening now in the system. Right now, what is happening in just taking an example of banking system is that you don't know what is happening in the bank. You just have an account and you know whatever is happening to your own account. But you don't know what happens behind the scene, what happens to the data in the data center, what other things are happening, what are the transactions could happen that could threaten your account, which is your data, because you don't own that yet. And it's immutable, as we said. You cannot really change anything that has happened in the history. That's why it's a perfect technology for record keeping. And it has multiple applications in record keeping as well. And disintermediation is all distributed and decentralized. There is no central house of control that if the data center dies, then the whole data is gone, or there is no such threats anymore in the system. And it injects collaboration. No longer, the world no longer will work with blockchain in a way that a smaller company cannot reach a huge organization, because it's a peer-to-peer. The smallest company can today now with blockchain collaborate with the big organizations directly without having to go through a lot of wholesalers or a lot of other intermediaries involved. So these are some of the advantages that blockchain technology will introduce to the world. But talking about these advantages, how can we map this now to logistics? We said that blockchain is a technology for sharing information. We all have the same information synchronized real time. And what does it mean in logistics? It means that the information such as the origin or authenticity of the product that is being shipped, that is being sent to a customer, now is shared with everyone in the network. And everyone in the network can now ensure that this is a genuine product. This is the product that we want, actually. And in benefits, if we want to translate it, then it's talking about decentralization and multiple owners. Now, not only the manufacturer is owning this data, but also the end user owns it, because the end user has all the right to know that they are actually buying genuine data, the genuine product. They're buying the right product that they're paying for. And then technology, we said, is a technology for sharing information which allows for multiple parties. And here, what do we mean by multiple parties in logistics is manufacturers, customers, suppliers. These are all parties that are involved in this chain, in this logistic chain that we call a supply chain. And these multiple owners of this data, now they have the right to actually make transaction of data, transaction of information real time with each other, and it's synchronized. So if the shipping company now has an objection because they cannot do this shipping for some reason, the manufacturer will find it out at the exact time that the shipping company actually adds this data to the chain. So a lot of time here is saved. A lot of time that is wasted today in real life is saved. And now these multiple parties whose entries are verified, therefore trusted. Verification of these entries and trusting these entries today is a big problem. For example, just giving an example of what can happen is what has happened to the biggest cyber attack of the century in Maersk case in 2017. Maersk is one of the biggest logistic company in the world, and they had an attack through a 12 people employees company in Ukraine that was attacked. They attacked the system and the whole system was off, and the whole shipping in the whole world, they didn't know what is happening for like some time, and that could actually put, for example, Japan in danger of not having enough food this is the type of security we are talking about, saving logistic and supply chain, but adding a technology like blockchain that can now verify every single transaction of data that is happening in this system, and also adds trust to this. If the system was on blockchain, their logistic system was on blockchain, then probably then this transaction that has caused this attack could easily be rejected, because the system would not allow this transaction to happen, transaction of data to happen. Meaning the customers can trust the third parties. This means the customers now can trust all the parties involved, and trust through design and rules and verify all this mutual consensus. This again also comes to some other cases of track and tracing food, ensuring the quality, ensuring, for example, for sustainability goals, you want to make sure that the product as an end user that you are receiving has actually gone through the process of manufacturing that the company is claiming is operating through. And the last step is that while these entries are verified and trusted, they need to form a public record visible to all. Now everyone who is involved in this network needs to be able to see that this is really happening. And all parties have access to data around the good, and this data cannot be deleted, this data cannot be manipulated with, this data cannot be changed. If anyone attempts to make any change, the whole network will find out and can easily excel the faulty node, the faulty party in the network. And how are we going to do this with C Productor? I will let Victoria to do a little bit of talking, because I have potential to talk a lot.
No, but I mean, we talk about Maersk and blockchain, and of course the step to Little Unreid in Holland is quite big, but actually it is not, because what Sara is talking a lot about is trust. And business is built on trust, and we want to be able to trust each other. And I always talk a lot about bringing my network around me with my companies that I work with, our clients, our partners, our suppliers, bring us together and build trust for all of the transactions. So blockchain is actually real democracy, I would say, democracy for real. So what we could do at CS Producte would be, because we are in the business of recycling, one of our unique selling points is that we sell material that are made from recycled PET bottles. But I also know in other parts of the world, they produce PET bottles at one end of the factory, and then they just bring it around the corner and they recycle them. So now we are in the recycling business, but the product has never been on the market. So of course we want to have a blockchain here where we can prove that this has been a consumer good, or this has been an industrial product that's been in the loop, and this is recycled. For sure, because we all know about business, sometimes it's not so clean. So this is a way of bringing a cleaner business. If we can provide a blockchain with the original of our product to our end customer, because we all know the market, the customer has the power now. So they demand the truth. And this is going to be a great way for us to give them the truth. But not only with just the product line, also to bring us together with logistics and so on. We send products to our customers. We have our own truck company. So most of the time we send the products ourselves, but sometimes we buy the transportation, and then suddenly they end up getting reloaded somewhere in Gothenburg, I don't know. And then we have the question on how many was on the truck. And there's no way for us to prove that we loaded everything. But if we have open transactions here, we can secure everything. And our machines connected, so we know exactly how many we produced. We know how much I took from my inventory. So you can have a fully trustable transaction all the way through.
Great. But now the question that can be asked is where exactly in this chain blockchain can help? Where exactly, we talk about all the application, but where exactly in which stage? In this this image, we can see six major stages, steps of the supply chain. And I am happy to say blockchain can actually help in each and every single step. And we will talk about it just quickly. Like in planning and forecasting, demand forecasting and planning by blockchain, that once you have everything on the chain, it's very easy to have a statistics of what has been happening and then automate these reports, these statistics and the overview that you will get through a smart contract, which is an application of blockchain, and then plan and forecast for the whole chain. And then procurement is all about, you know, the career contract management, the manufacturing ecosystem, how much is going to be to be manufactured, and how much, when is this going to be sent to the clients, to the customers, how is it going to be sent, and all of these again can be pre-authorized with the smart contracts, and we have quite a number of applications of it. And supply chain financials, we don't need to talk about how blockchain can help with the financials, because we all got, probably a lot of people still think blockchain and Bitcoin are the same, but they are not. They are not. Blockchain is the technology behind Bitcoin, but the first implication of blockchain technology was in finance industry, and therefore it is probably one of the most matured applications of it as well by today. Yeah. And just imagine a world that all these different players in the chain throughout the world, in Asia, Africa, Europe, America, now they can transact in real time with each other. And how much faster this whole chain could work, how much faster this could be. And execution and operation, when it comes to brokerage and freight forwarding, digital bill of lading, trade compliances, these are all a lot of bureaucracy and paperwork today that could easily be digitalized and then tokenized and then done through smart contracts and human beings not being involved with it at all. And asset management, where you can actually lease your asset, when you can insure your asset, when you can maintain your asset, your, let's say, your manufacturing plant, whatever you have, you know what is happening, everything is clear for you, therefore you can actually have everything, the leasing and insuring and everything done digitally through a smart contract, through blockchain itself again. Mm. And last but not least, visibility. Everyone, all these players in the chain now can see what is happening, yeah, and can automate a lot of the work within the chain itself. And we just talked about the application that CE Productor is visioning to build, but this application is going to add some value. What are the values that this application is going to add is digital ownership certificate. Now there is a digital ownership certificate of the product that is sent to the clients. There is asset assembly and tracking, proof of origin. Now the client can easily, the customer can easily see where the product is really coming from. Trusted maintenance tracking, integrated financial transactions. You have clients in different countries, and that the transactions today are not as simple as it could be. And collaborative product master data. These are the values that such solution would add. But such solution would also need enablers. Maybe you want to talk about the enablers more here.
No.
No, maybe about, to keep it simple here, to be able to build such solution, you need to have integrated systems. And that is what we are.
Now I see where you're getting. Yeah, but one of our, I mean, to run a company or whatever right now, you need a lot of systems. And we talk about ERP systems on how you financially follow up your company and how you plan your production and so on. And you need a lot of systems. And with technology, there are many fantastic ideas right now on the table. So that's a problem for people running companies because you have all these systems. So when you're in one system, you're interrupted and you have to go to the next one and your efficiency is a little bit disturbed. So what we are building now is like an interface where we input data from a lot of different spaces. And I heard, I think it was Erik that was just here, that he said the most important thing you have to concentrate is that everything talks with everything. So you can use the same solutions for a lot of things. So this is what we are really looking into, integrating important data, data collection, so we can build smart solutions and do the quickest, smartest ideas for what we are doing.
And we are doing this through trusted devices that we are using in your plant and the asset management systems that we are building, the infield interface that we are building, that which is a great surprise that C-Productor will introduce soon to the market. But all these enablers that we are, the ecosystem that we are building together with them, is to enable them to empower such solution.
Yeah. But it's all about bringing the network closer together, everyone closer together, so we can do good business together.
And add value to the society.
Yes.
And I can see that we don't have much time left. I'm just going to sum it up and talk about the six main blockchain use cases in logistics, as we just talked today, is about the goods tracking, to be able to track the product, and the modified freight and transportation, payment procedures, to make all these payment settlements and all these settlements much easier and much faster, the remittances much faster, genuineness verification, to verify that as an end user, to verify that you are buying a genuine product, and fair cooperation, where you can see that, okay, because right now, today, we don't have a fair cooperation in supply chains. There are wholesalers that benefit a lot more than actually the organization, the companies that are doing the real job. And this is not what we want in our world. And dispute settlements. And once everything is very clear and very transparent, it makes all this dispute much easier and much faster, quicker as well. And free the leaders' time to think about the brighter future of the organizations coming up, as C-Productor is doing right now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I just, wow. Thank you. I've learned so much for this short amount of time that I've, I think more now than I ever did in school.
Wow.
I just want to start off with asking you, Tobias, is there any questions from the audience? No? Do we have any questions from... Yes? Sorry. I'm just going to get you. Throw it. No, don't do that.
Microphone catch.
Exactly. New sport.
Yeah, I was just curious. Did it take a lot of time for you to integrate the system in your business?
We are doing it right now.
Okay.
And yes, it's going to take time.
Okay.
Because it's pretty much new technology, and for us as a small company, of course, it's a lot of time. But I think it's very well invested time.
Okay.
That's going to give me a lot of fantastic time for the future. I was talking to Sara yesterday about Hans Rosling. I was trying to explain who he was. And he mentioned in his TED talk about his mother that always talked about the fantastic washing machine. That the fantastic technology of the washing machine that did the laundry for her so she could take him to the library or read books for him. So technology will save us time. So yes, it will take a little bit of time in the beginning, but it will be so well worth it.
Okay.
Yeah.
And also, would it be great for like main-on-demand production?
Or is it come again?
Would it be a suitable system for using for main-on-demand production?
Definitely.
The blockchain is like internet.
Okay.
Do you have a use of internet in there?
No. None. Yeah, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Then you will have it blockchain. But they they actually call it Internet of Values.
Okay.
And there is no industry or no business that cannot benefit as long as you need trust, you need transparency, and you need speed of transaction. And I think in today's world, every business, every industry needs that.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Because when... as I'm constantly saying, bringing the chain closer together. I mean, we all saw now what happened with the coronavirus, and suddenly we were a little bit stressed about having our slim supplies, chains, and everything. But still, if we have this open network, the blockchain between each other, the whole chain, so to speak, we will be able to trust each other, because maybe I can see my customer's inventory at my factory, so I know exactly what that person needs at exactly the right time. So, but if we bypass the supplier, I'm not talking about taking away jobs or anything here, but if we have the system talking to each other, trusting each other, we can really start giving high value for the organizations all over. Everyone will benefit from it.
Yeah.
Back with the mic.
Who else is involved in your system, for example? Are you many actors or many like?
We are looking into seeing what customers that will be the perfect fit, and also on the supply chain. So we are mainly now doing inventory, seeing what systems they are talking to, because there is obstacles with this. It's not a quick fix. You won't do it in 2 days' time, because...
there are different stakeholders involved, that these stakeholders have their own system and their own challenges. Yes, it requires sometimes to plan, because you want to make sure that the data flow is also the right flow.
Yeah.
And the right data is going to the right place as well, you know. And so to plan it, yes, it is. You need some time to plan it with the stakeholders properly.
And you probably need to sell the system as well, right?
Maybe.
Well, you can. There is a lot of different ways you can approach this. You can either, as an organization, build a private blockchain for your own self and your own stakeholders that you do business mm-hmm. with, or you can actually start building a public blockchain that now can be introduced to other supply chains, that other companies can also use it. So if we decide that, okay, we're going to have a private blockchain for Sea Predictor, it is possible, mm-hmm. but we could also go for a public blockchain that can be a platform of service for to other companies.
I think that you guys, you should continue talking. thank you so much for your good questions, better than any of mine. And I would like to say a big thank you to Victoria and Sara.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.